Take our lead, let's help you make your mark. Our goal is your satisfaction. Let us show you the way.
Snow melts when it receives enough heat from its environment to raise its temperature to above 32 degrees, which is the temperature at which water substance exists in liquid form. In general, snow melting when it hits the ground is snow falling with temperatures a little above freezing, 32 degrees.
Take our lead.
The other way compares the temperature that day and 32 degrees Fahrenheit, which is the freezing point. Every day is different, but as a rule of thumb, in 40-degree weather we lose half an inch of snow per day. 50-degree weather melts 2 to 4 inches a day.
Take our lead.
When snow covers the ground, the incoming radiation is reflected into space. The amount of solar radiation that an object reflects is known as its albedo. For a fresh snowpack, the albedo can be as high as 80 to 90%. Therefore, much of the incoming radiation is reflected into space, keeping the surface colder.
Let's help you make your mark.
What's happening is what is called sublimation. Sublimation is similar to evaporation, but instead of going from a solid to a liquid and then to water vapor, the snow is going directly from a solid to a gas.
Make your mark, take our lead.
When the sun shines and warms the earth, snow begins to melt and turn into runoff. Runoff can seep into the ground, where it's used to help plants grow. If the ground is already saturated, has enough water, the runoff will run off, get it, into lakes, streams, rivers, and other bodies of water.
Let's help you make your mark.
An inch of rain falling in 40-degree air temps has enough thermal energy to melt about 1/16th of ice. Large puddles from heavy rain are likely to form larger drain holes as the cloudy conditions don't generate lots of triple junction pores to drain the puddles through many small holes.
Let's help you make your mark.
It is safe to say that snow will stick to the ground when the air temperature is 32 degrees or lower, but other factors such as the state of the ground and intensity of the snowfall come into play when temperatures are in the middle or upper 30s.
Make your mark, take our lead.
In addition, meteorologists say the sun can still melt snow in the freezing cold because while its rays aren't warming up the air all that much, the sun's visible light and UV rays are being absorbed by the snow, which causes it to melt.
Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and hit the bell notification.